sort of redone it. We've upped the ante. We've made it work. We've made it fresh. We've made it fluid. We've made it sexy. We've made it hot.
That describes Cheer star Bebe Neuwirth in the role of Lola, the devil's saucy sidekick. In the show, Lola and the Devil, played by Victor Garber, team up to trap a baseball fan who's willing to sell his soul just to see the Yankees lose a pennant.
I have a brother and a father who are huge sports fans and sort of jocks themselves. So I've grown. Actually, baseball is the first thing that I played, the first sport that I played. And when I went to school and joined the softball team, I had to get used to a softball because I was throwing hard balls when I was a kid with my brother and my father.
Getting into the baseball spirit, the show drafted current Yankees coach Del Alston to coach the cast on their baseball moves.
Throw. Right at him. You know, I'm never going to make the pros, you know, major league-wise, but I can do the next best thing is do it on stage.
Anyway, you saw the ground ball hit the shorts over there. Here's a throw to first.
Yes, that's the voice of the Yankees, Mel Allen, lending the Hall of Fame touch to the new production.
When they said that Mel Allen wanted to do this, I flipped, because there's the authentic sound. There's the sound of the Yankees that we all know, right? I find out today, talking to them, that they did this in the original show, and they had his voice in the original show. So we thought we had this big idea, like no one would ever think of this, and Mel Allen says George Abbott thought of this 40 years ago. It's sort of amazing. It's great. Great to have him.
Producing any show at Broadway these days takes a lot of heart, and Damn Yankees seems to have it.
But the combination of the music and baseball, it's kind of unbeatable.
Speaking of unbeatable, you'll have to see the show to find out if those Damn Yankees do get beat.
Damn Yankees is the only musical about baseball that has ever been successful. It was one of the longest-running shows in the history of Broadway. It won 8 Tony Awards in 1955. It was made into a successful movie. I think the fact that it's about baseball is what makes it so universal.
Well, now in this loving revival directed by Jack O'Brien, it looks to be almost 40 years later, once again, a slam bang smash with that still wonderful plot about the Washington, D.C. man who sold his soul to the devil so that his ball club, the woeful Washington Senators, could win the American League pennant and finally beat out those damn New York Yankees. The most heartsick of Senator fans, a married middle-aged man named Joe Boyd, who makes a deal with the devil to become... Young Joe Hardy, the long ball hitter the Senators so desperately need. Trouble is, young Joe will always remain in love with the wife he left, which displeases the devil, who sends in Bebe Neuwirth as his best home wrecker, Lola. Well, despite the worst efforts of Lola and Victor Garber as Satan himself, here a Mr. Applegate, it looks as though Joe may win the Senators the pennant and outwit the powers of hell. After all, he, like the show, has style and wit and spirit and miles and miles and miles of heart.
Bebe Neuwirth and Victor Garber as the devil, with autographed pictures of Joe McCarthy and J. Edgar Hoover in his lair, do stop the show, and if you're keeping score, Broadway starts the season with a big, solid hit.
Whatever Lola wants, Lola gets.
If you didn't know it was Cheers TV star Bebe Neuwirth, you would never recognize her in her blonde wig as Lola, trying to seduce Jared Emick as a man who sells his soul to beat those damn Yankees.
Our love will keep, oh girl, till then.
Dennis Kelly has a wonderful voice and a genuine manner as Joe Boyd, who would give almost anything except the love of his wife to play baseball for the Washington Senators. A deal with the devil turns him into the young hitter.
Did you? I don't believe this. Wham! And now you're Joe.
Victor Garber is sensational as the devilish Applegate. Bebe Neuwirth looks dynamite and has a nice sense of humor as the devil's helper.
We would rather we got each other.
Director Jack O'Brien has been faithful to the spirit of Damn Yankees, which opened in 1955, written by George Abbott and Douglas Wallop, with words and music by Richard Adler and Jerry Ross. Aside from some revisions in the script, this is a revival of an almost 40-year-old musical. It doesn't have the high concept or the technological glitz of some musicals on Broadway now, but that's basically its charm. It's small in size. It's warm, funny. It's almost cozy. The best thing about Damn Yankees is it has heart. I'm Pia Lindstrom for News 4 New York.
Back now, 7:30, joined in Studio 1A by the cast of the Broadway revival of Damn Yankees.
A great slugger we haven't got.
A great pitcher we haven't got. A great ball club we haven't got. What do we got?
We've got love. Keep that old horse before the car. First, you gotta have heart. You gotta have heart. You gotta have heart.
Wow.
We could use backup singers like you guys every morning around here.
Gotta have heart, gotta have heart, gotta have voice, too.
Yeah, that's right.
My goodness.
It sounds great at this early hour.
Really does. When was this first on Broadway? 55?
55. Yeah.
40 years ago?
And it's going strong on Broadway right now, right? And George Abbott, who is 107 years old.
Tomorrow.
Yeah. Tomorrow. Happy birthday, George.
He directed the original, right? Yeah.
Uh-huh. And he's involved.
And wrote it?
And it is involved in this production isn't he?
Yeah, he sure is.
Wow, what an inspiration.
Oh, yeah.
A little bit later on, Bebe Neuwirth is going to be here, too.
That's right. Lola. Whatever Lola wants, Lola gets.
I don't know if she will this morning, but yes, she'll be on. Thanks very much, group.
Mary Elisa Reig, we're in the audience. The future bride had no idea what was about to happen. Watch the expressions on their faces.
Is Mary Elisa Reig in the house?
Yeah.
Could you please stand up and identify yourself?
What is this?
There she is, yes. Now, Mr. Derek Fuller wants to know if you will accept his invitation.
Well, talk about bringing the house down. Obviously, Mary said yes, and on Live at 5, Garrett explained why he did it.
Mary and I got back together again about 2 years ago at another Broadway show. And I thought, what better way to get engaged in New York than on Broadway?
Damn Yankees not only has heart, but also the soul of old Broadway, revived intact from the days when shows were produced without gimmicks and special effects.
I think one of the reasons this show is so successful is because it harkens back to another time in the theater, when there was nothing in the way of the audience and the actors, when it was just about that experience. as opposed to effects.
What are we waiting for?
It's a simple story set in simpler times. In return for his soul, the devil transforms aging fan Joe Boyd into a youthful baseball hero who leads the Senators to victory.
I've seen the most cynical, jaded people, friends of mine, come to the show and say, I had the best time, and I cried, and I laughed.
Little Lola, what's it?
I can't describe the state of mind when I'm dancing. I think that's how you know that it's something really spectacular, when you can't describe the state of mind. They don't have words for that.
Sign yourself, you're through.
People who, they go to Broadway plays and want to see movies duplicated on Broadway. You can't do that. I mean, we don't have those kind of special effects. I mean, some of the shows come fairly close to it in size and whatever they can do. But here, I think the performers, we carry the show. And boy, that's nice. And
mainly the players, don't you think?
Go, 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 jump, go!
Go like a bat out of you know where.
Go, 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 go!
Oh, let him go, go, go!
The devil doesn't win, you know. What wins is true love. And it's corny, and it's sentimental, and it's also beautiful.
Now, all any Broadway show needs to be a hit is Dick Latessa. And here to prove my point is the gypsy of the decade. And the bitch of Broadway, Cynthia on Rubia and Company!
Who needs a star when we got Latessa? Who needs a kid named Broderick? Who do you get whose fee is much less? So wanna know who? Get Dick. Who needs a former Brady chick? Who doesn't need his own private dress? So wanna know who? Get Dick. Glenn Close has got a great hype, and Brooke is the beauty queen type. So Dick has a head full of gray. He's better than Faye Dunaway. He does every matinee.
Big up Vanessa, we got Natessa. Big up Vanessa, we got Dick. Who do you get instead of Vanessa? Wanna know who?
Swayze in the house. Is Julie Andrews in the house? Is Rosie O'Donnell in the house? Is Michael Palin in the house? Is Jerry Lewis in the house?
Hey, ladies!
For there is an element of doubt.
Last time our national pastime was brought to the stage with so much fun. Don't think for a minute it's just 'cause I'm in it. Damn Yankees has hit a home run. The devil made me say that.
He's shooting a step from Hannibal. Go, 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 go. Like a bat out of you know where.
Shoot the stuff from Hannibal Mo.
That's the stuff.
ladies and gentlemen, Gwen Burton, Gene Stapleton, and George Abbott.
The three of us were together for the opening of Damn Yankees. Gene and I were on stage, and Mr. Abbott, who had co-written the book and directed the entire production, was backstage.
We were all younger then. But not one of us was as young in spirit and enthusiasm or as old in the wisdom of the theater as Mr. Abbott.
Now, today... today he is still involved in the profession for which he has given so much. And a few days, he will celebrate his 107th birthday. What do you say we get on with this, Mr. Abbott?
It's a good idea. On with the show.